The bladder snail, Physella acuta, they are extremely adaptable to pH, temperature, and water hardness. Really, I introduced them to my scut glass or scut project 7 or 8 months ago. In this glass, nothing really survived except for bladder snails. This is the only larger animal that survived in this glass, although there's almost nothing in there. It's very low oxygen, highly nutrient rich and nutrient dense, but there's no artificial light or anything, and these guys, they're super hard. They reproduce in a hermaphroditic way and are capable of self-fertilization and can multiply extremely rapidly, especially if you have high nutrient tanks. High nutrient tanks means, in this case, if you have lots of excess fish food. They have an extremely important ecological role because they are scavengers that feed on algae, detritus, decaying plant matter, and leftover fish food. They are useful in cleaning, but can also overpopulate aquariums very, very fast. So originally they were native to North America, but now they are found on every continent except Antarctica, which is quite impressive. They are often introduced through the aquarium trade or even ballast water because they travel ships also. They are spread all across Europe, for instance. So I actually got them originally through some wild plants I got through my tanks, and then they've been in my tanks for the last 15-20 years at least. They are naturally found in ponds, streams, ditches, and lakes, and they thrive in nutrient-rich, but also in low oxygen and even polluted waters.